All right, guys, today, good morning. It's Tuesday. Today, eyeball update. Doing good. I don't feel like there's anything in my eye anymore. Very little blurriness. But I'm good. I'm not nauseous anymore. So all's good there. Let me answer a question. I got a question about the eye drops that I received, I guess when I was in the emergency room. Okay. They put numbing eye drops in your eye so they can dig, okay? They dug in my eye 2 Sundays ago with a needle, literally, like a sewing needle. And they numb your eye with a drop or two, and it's like, it feels like battery acid, you know, it burns, and then it numbs it. And they can sit there and dig all they want. You feel a little pressure, but you don't feel any pain. And I mean, they're not digging, but I mean, you know, they're making contact with your eyeball or with your eyelid. With a needle to pull debris away. And that's what they did that Sunday. Those were the numbing drops. They gave me a prescription for an ointment that you put on your bottom eyelid, just on the inside of your eyelid, and then as you blink, the ointment coats your eye. And then that was 2 Sundays ago. The next Saturday, I have my boys. That was last Saturday. Yeah, that was a week ago. That was like 8 days ago, 9 days ago. I went back to urgent care, and then they sent me to the ER. So at the ER, the optometrist or ophthalmologist, whatever the hell they're called, looked at my eye, took a picture of my eye, and showed me the mark. That was concerning urgent care. Urgent care was concerned that I was getting an ulcer on my eye. And so she sent me to the ER, they called ahead, and they took me right back, me and the boys and all that. They didn't give me any drops there, they gave me a prescription for drops. The prescription for drops is not the numbing drops, so that was the question I got. Are the drops that they gave me the numbing drops? No, the drops that they gave me are a strong antibiotic. That I had to put in my eye every 3 hours, twice, 2 drops every 3 hours that I'm awake and till the bottle ran out. So the bottle ran out and you just drop it in your eye. Didn't hurt, no burning, actually felt good. And that's what those were. They weren't the numbing drops that they gave me the prescription for. So I just wanted to clear that up, make sure you guys understood that. This weekend was crazy. Saturday, I worked. We did the 2 pine straw jobs. It was really windy. I did the 2 pine straw jobs and 2 lawns and a house wash. Now, I had every intention of filming the house wash. And when I got there, I didn't do the pine straw. I was like, well, I want to do a pressure wash video, so I'll just do pressure wash. So I called the customer and I said, hey, I'll be there at 11. And I got there about 11:30, and the driveway and the street was full of cars. I was like, shoot. So I knocked on the door and I was like, hey, do you need me to come back? Are you like having a party or something? He's like, no. I was like, well, the cars, will you be able to move the cars? Just so overspray doesn't get on them. And he was like, yeah. So he moved the cars, but they had a house full of people. So I didn't think it was right for me to be working cameras and stuff with everybody there and stuff. So I don't know who's there. And it's a very rich neighborhood. So who knows who's in that house, you know what I mean? And so I didn't think people would want, you know, their vehicles out in the street and stuff like that video. So I ended up not doing the video, which kind of sucked because then I didn't put a vlog up. So Sunday, I'm like, well, I'm going to go jog Tybee Beach. I've only been to Tybee once, and that was back in like the fall of 2004. And I never went back because I was kind of disappointed in it, because I was still like fresh from Fort Lauderdale Beach, where I grew up, and going to that beach. So I went to Tybee on Sunday, and I videoed a really nice, beautiful run from South Tybee, where the Korean War Memorial is, a placard at the end of US 80. From there, I jogged all the way to North Tybee and went up the lighthouse and filmed around the lighthouse and then came down and then jogged the sand all the way back. I had like an hour and 5 minutes of video, all destroyed because of wind noise. I used this camera, the Sony point and shoot, instead of using this camera, the Sony action cam with the windsock. That would, you know, that's without the wind, this would be terrible. And then with it, this really helps with the wind. So this is what I've been using for my action. I didn't realize it, and I brought that camera that I'm on now, and the wind is terrible. So I just said, you know what, I'm gonna do this again, but I'm gonna do it right, and I'm gonna bring this camera with this mic instead. Now, I cannot put this mic onto that camera because that camera doesn't have an external mic jack like this does. This has an external mic jack, see? A little 3.5 millimeter RCA type. So I wish that camera did, but it doesn't. That would be the ultimate if it did, but it don't. So, such is life. So we got this, the Sony action cam for that. So I should have had this and I didn't. So I said, you know what? I'm not gonna screw around with these people because this is an important run. That was a really nice, beautiful run on the beach. It was gorgeous out. We ran on the road all the way to the lighthouse. We went up the lighthouse. We circled the lighthouse. I was terrified because of the heights. And I came down, I figured this might be good for the kids. I came down and then I ran the sand and I got some pretty good video of that. And when I came home, I was doing the edits, I deleted it all. I was so frustrated with all the noise, I said, screw it, I deleted it. So that leaves me owing you a running video on the beach. So I'm gonna have to David Hasselhoff it for you guys. And that'll be a sight to turn many straight women gay. And gay men straight, and I'm gonna have to I'm gonna David Hasselhoff it for you, and I'm gonna take the kids to the lighthouse probably this weekend, depending on this hurricane that's coming. That's another thing we need to talk about. Shit, Earl, we got Hurricane Matthew coming, and it's gonna hit us. I mean, there's no way it's not going to. If the eye doesn't make landfall, I mean, it's gonna be so close, it's gonna be disgusting. As a category 4, I believe, maybe a 3, but who cares? 3, 4, Jesus, man. So it's gonna get pretty sporty here come I guess Thursday night, Friday, and I'm gonna have my kids this weekend. So I told Christina, my ex-wife, that if it's like a 3 or better, to take the kids and go to her uncle's in South Carolina. He's inland. I'll give up my weekend for their safety, for sure. For all their safety, for sure. So she should do that. But if it's gonna be offshore where we're gonna get like Hurricane 2 and less, but we're not gonna get the surge, because the surge is what's gonna destroy everything, then, you know, I'll take the kids and we'll have a hurricane party here for the weekend. So we're gonna have to see how that goes. I got the guys are out mowing today. And I'm gonna go and I'm gonna make good on the other part that I owe you. I owe you guys a house wash. So we're gonna go do a big two-story house wash today. And we're gonna start it off from the beginning as a basic guy just like you. And as you see on the ground here, standard bleach, okay? This here is your great value. Standard bleach. This is 8.25% sodium hydrochloride. Sorry. Right here. Let's see if that'll focus. Hopefully that focused. That's your active ingredient, sodium hydrochloride, 8.25%. This is concentrated. Okay, this is the concentrated bleach. If you don't get concentrated, then chances are you're getting 5 or 6% sodium hydrochloride, and you might as well not even show up, because that will take a whole lot to make that happen. So I took that bleach on Saturday, and I did that two-story house. There's 9 gallons here. I did that two-story house. I filled up a 5-gallon bucket with about 4 gallons of bleach, and I did that house and poured some bleach back into my onboard tank that I have. Now, here's the problem. My onboard tank has a hole in it, and I'll show you guys that later. So I can't fill it up anymore. I have to drain the bleach out of it and use a 5-gallon bucket. So just like you guys, we're gonna do basic pressure wash job on a 2-story house. We're gonna soft wash it using the black fan tip and the pink 2-story tip. We're gonna use a 4-gallon per minute pressure washer. It doesn't matter what the PSI are. It's 3,600 PSI, but it doesn't matter. What matters is it's 4 gallons per minute. So it's gonna be pushing a certain amount of volume of water, and that is what helps you get the height, not pressure. Pressure fizzles out as soon as it leaves the orifice. As soon as it leaves the orifice, you lose pressure, okay? Pressure means absolutely nothing when it comes to house washing. It's all in the gallons per minute. So anything under 4 gallons per minute, it's a little bit harder for you. You need a ladder or an extension pole or something. 4 gallons per minute is your basic entry-level commercial style pressure washer that you can use for high gable roofs, okay? And I'm gonna show you that today. From the ground, you'll easily be able to reach up to your high peaks on a 2-story house, all right? Anything over 4 gallons per minute, 5 gallons per minute, you're doing really good. You start getting into like 6, 7, 8 gallon per minute pressure washers, you start running the risk of cavitating your pump off of a garden hose. The home may not be able to deliver enough water. Now, people say to me, oh, a house only puts out 2 or 3 gallons per minute. You're using 4 gallons per minute. Mathematically, that's not right. Now, a house will put out, you know, whatever it puts out, but a 4 gallon per minute pump, or any pump for that matter, is drawing. So what little bit of resistance is in the pipes and is at your spigot is overcome by the pressure washer helping to draw. So you're getting more than if you just turn on your garden hose and time how long it takes to fill a 5-gallon pail. You know, if it takes you, you know, a minute and a half or 2 minutes, then you say 2.5 gallons per minute. How can that feed a 4-gallon per minute pressure washer? Well, because you're overcoming the resistance. You're helping. You know, if you siphon something, let's say you're siphoning gas out of a can with a hose, it's gonna flow at a certain rate. If you add vacuum to that siphon, it's gonna flow at a much faster rate. So you got pressure from the city pushing the water, and then there's restriction in your pipes, your 90 degrees, your spigot. But then you overcome that resistance with the pump helping to pull it out. But that overcoming of resistance is only going to do so much until it's not enough and you cavitate your pump. 8 gallon per minute, you're gonna cavitate your pump. You're not gonna get enough water out of a garden hose to do that. So that's when you need a huge tank to feed your pump. And you hook up a garden hose to your huge tank, and there's a float that turns on and off. So the homeowner, their water source, continues to fill your big 200 gallon tank, and that big 200 gallon tank has an ass load of weight and water pushing down on the hose that's connected to your pressure washer, and your pressure washer pump is sucking water from that 250 gallon thingy, and you gotta have a certain size hose, and it's gotta be a certain type of hose that it doesn't suck closed. Like a radiator hose on a car, you want that spring in there so the radiator doesn't suck, the water pump doesn't suck the hose shut and you overheat. Same thing with a hose coming from the 250 gallon or 200 gallon or 150 gallon tank on your trailer or truck or whatever that feeds your pressure washer pump. You want a good hose that's not gonna suck close and cavitate your pump and then burn it up. Okay, so that was weird. We were outside and that camera battery just completely died on me, so I just plugged it in. But what I was saying was, let's get out of here. Okay, so what I was saying was, you don't want that hose to shut on you. You want a good, solid, strong hose that's gonna allow the water to get sucked by the pump from your big old reservoir tank. So I use a 4 gallon per minute pressure washer. It's got the Honda GX270, I believe, or it could be a 290. I think it's a GX270. I use a 4 gallon per minute pump by AR. I don't remember what AR stands for, but it's an AR pump. And there's my neighbor looking at me like I'm crazy, but she knows I vlog and she watches my videos. No, not Sarah. You guys are getting to know my people here. Dang it, what was I...
gonna say? Now I forget. I don't know. We gotta go to work, guys. We gotta go to work. Let's open up the cage for the boydies. Hey guys. Good morning. And I'm gonna go ahead, hook up my trailer, and we're gonna go do a nice two-story house wash. All right, guys, let me show you what we got for today for our basic job with our basic setup here. We got our garden hose, 100 feet rolled up onto a Roughneck brand reel. And that's plumbed straight to the back there of the pump, right there. And we got 150 feet of good quality rawhide, high pressure, pressure wash hose. I believe this is rated to 5,000 PSI, but this is the good stuff. This isn't your cheap stuff you buy at like Blue Hawk, like Home Depot or Lowe's. This is the good stuff, it's expensive stuff. And this comes in and is plumbed right in to the out of the pressure washer. And then here is your siphon with our hose here. So we're gonna siphon this 5-gallon bucket of bleach and a little soap mixed in. 1 ounce of soap per gallon of bleach. So we'll put about 4 gallons of bleach in here, about 4 ounces of dishwashing soap, laundry soap, anything to make it soapy, little sudsy. And then we just take the end here with a PVC pipe, and the PVC pipe holds it down so it won't float up. So that holds it down at the bottom of the bucket. You got your hose, you stick it here, and then your pressure wash. Underneath my pallet, I have an extra 50 feet of high pressure hose, and I have my wand. And it is, I guess, 36 inches, I don't know. And I got the pink tip in it right now. Okay, we have 4 gallons of concentrated regular household bleach, 8.25% sodium hydrochloride. And I'm gonna go pick up about 2 more gallons at the store here just to play it safe because we're doing a pretty big house. It'll take about 3 gallons. I always like to have a little extra because you never know when a neighbor comes out and says, can you do mine too? And then our pressure washer is the, like I said, it's the Honda GX270. I put a new pull cord on it. You can watch a video of that under pressure wash video. I believe I have that pressure wash video playlist. It's a really, really nice machine. It has a cover for the exhaust, but I took it off because it was broke and rattling. I bought this machine used for $800 with a brand new pump. Just recently, we serviced the oil in the pump, and we serviced the oil in the machine. There's a video on how to service the oil in the pump. Probably about a month ago, I did it during, I believe, Hurricane Hermine. Four weeks ago or whatever, I did videos on servicing this thing. And then we got a 5-gallon jug of gas with about 2 gallons in it. That's it, guys. That's our setup. Okay. Garden hose, pressure washer. You can have that on wheels. I have it bolted to the pallet. Some gas, a bucket to throw your bleach and soap in. I have this built up so I can slide stuff under it. And you can lock your tailgate to at least slow people down from stealing your stuff. In the back of my truck here, in there, I got my surface cleaner. Hey, buddy. I got my surface cleaner with me. It's the Briggs & Stratton surface cleaner. Somebody asked me, what is surface cleaning? That's surface cleaning. Doing your surface, doing concrete surfaces, brick, your driveway, sidewalks, concrete floors, use a surface cleaner, and this thing spins around super high speed and washes large areas very fast. You could do this driveway in about 15 minutes compared to probably about 2 hours with a wand. So that's the deal there. All right, so let's go grab a couple gallons of bleach to have a little extra. I got enough soap mixed into those gallons of bleaches already, just a little dish soap, a drip into each one, ready to rock. And my big chemical tank that I had here punctured, so we're just going to forego that. Screw it. We don't need it. Honestly, we don't need it. And this allows me to have a little bit more room for what I want. You can do everything with... It's a little bit more convenient because then I can pour 15 gallons at a time, but really don't need it. Let me show you one more thing. All right, that's a 15-gallon drum of bleach, AquaGuard chlorinating sanitizer. Okay, this is something you can buy in bulk at a pool store. Active ingredient, 10.5% sodium hydrochloride, compared to the bleach that's in my truck right now, 8.25%. That 2% difference makes a huge difference. Okay, this goes much farther. But bleach doesn't stay good forever. So if you're not going to use this up in like 3 or 4 weeks, I wouldn't recommend buying it, because it's going to start losing its potency. So if you can find good deals on household 8.25% bleach, then just do it. If you're just doing like a house here and a house there. But once you start getting into the bigger stuff, more work, then you can, if you can keep it away from your exhaust, maybe put this on the other side. You can cut a hole in your wood, drop this down, and siphon straight out of this, out of right here. You can siphon right out of this. And when you need more bleach, you go to the store, you pull out the old, and you drop in your new one and throw a strap over it, and you're done. All right, so that's something to think about. And there you go. So with this setup right here, I can work from my truck, pressure wash. I can tow my trailer right here, and so I can go do leaf cleanups, you know, fall cleanups, holiday cleanups. I can do stuff like that and pressure wash a home. So I mean, I can head out and I could do like $200-$300 jobs, full leaf and lawn cleanup, pine cones, pine needles, rake it all up, clean it all up, bag it all up, put it on the curb for the county to take for free, which saves the customer money, pull out my hoses, wash their house, have everything ready to go, do their surface cleaning, everything. You know, that'd be like a $300, $400 job. Their house is ready to go for the holidays. They're done for a year. And that's it. And I can tow my trailer right here and have my pressure wash set up right there. So that's why I built that onto a pallet a long time ago, so I can move it around. And I can also pull this off if I need the bed of my truck. I can pull this off, put it right on my little 4x8 trailer that I have in the backyard and tow it around. You guys have all seen that. So that's our setup for fall 2016, pressure wash setup for fall 2016. I guess that finishes it. We did talk about it in another video, but yeah, that should pretty much finish it. So let's go to work. Okay, so we got to the job. We're at our first job. Well, we're at our pressure wash job for the day. And first thing we do, we stick our yard sign out. So all the neighbors that are now going to hear a whole lot of noise are going to have an opportunity to see that big old yard sign. What I do, what I charge, how to contact me. That is the most important, guys. Get that signage out there, okay? Also, what I do, what I charge, how to contact me. You notice my name's not on there taking up space? Who gives a shit? Car pulls up beside you at a red light. Oh, look at that. House wash. Oh, look at the prices. Oh, write that number down or take a picture. Boom. There you go. They got you. Who cares what my name is? When I answer the phone and I say, Tremors, it's a wet day at Tremors, then they figure out my name, right? So there you go. Door magnet. What you do, what you charge, how to contact you. Now, a door magnet, hopefully they have a little bit more time. So I got in there, driveway, sidewalk, patio cleaning, licensed, insured, flat rate pricing. There you go. So as all these other people are driving around or have their per thousand square foot call for a free quote, right there, right there, they're done. They call me because they want my business, or they want me to do the work. They don't care about nothing else. They just, usually what they say is, does that include my house? Where do you live? Yes, it does. So there you go. Car magnets, door magnets, whatever you want to call them, put them all around. Very important, yard sign. Carry one or two with you. Stick them out on the job. Put one at the entranceway, okay? First things first, you get to your site, you do a little quick survey, you note the things that you got to worry about. Stuff on the door, but it's behind a glass door. I do not open doors, so that thing hanging is perfectly safe. I'm looking and I see nothing else that I have to worry about. Patio furniture, I'll move that out of the way. We got some high peaks. Notice I did not bring a ladder. Don't need one. I can reach these peaks with my 4 gallon per minute and my pink tip. Look at this. Screened in back porch. Let's go talk about it. All right, back porch. Carpet on the ground. I already told my customer I do not go inside screen porches. This is housekeeping. You got to clean inside your own porch. If you want me to do it, I'm going to charge you for housekeeping. I don't go in screen porches. I will if they want me to, but I don't. So she was like, oh, no, that's fine. We'll rinse it. Because usually behind the screen, you're just going to have loose dirt. She can go in there with a little duster and clean her porch. And I'm not going to have standing water or anything like that to worry about. High peaks, gutters. The gutters will get clean. They'll be nice. All these gutters are tan, so they're going to come up really nice. And they're vinyl, not aluminum. They have aluminum downspouts, though. Too easy. The fan will avoid it. We're going to low pressure rinse around it and let it run down, but we're going to avoid direct contact on the fan. All this will get cleaned. And then look at the mildew. That's a lot of mildew. So I'll try to set the camera up here and let you guys watch it just dissolve in real time. We're going to do this whole house, low pressure. It's called soft wash. We're going to use the black fan tip and we're going to use the pink second story tip. Those are linked. You can see the second story tips in my description below this video. So click the down arrow if you're watching me on your phone. And go down below the comments and you'll see all the links I have to everything that you can buy and do exactly what I'm doing right now, all from Amazon, shipped to your door. And if you're a Prime member, you can get it all milled free. Real high. Real high peaks. No problem. My little rig right here, we're going to do it all. No ladder. And we're going to do it all from the ground. No issues. You guys ready to do this? Let the water run through a little bit, make sure there's nothing blocking, no issues with my hoses. Let it run through. Also, I have my siphon open at this point, and I should be able to feel slight suction here on my siphon port, which I do, slight suction. When the pump is on and more volume's passing, this will really be pulling hard. So I know that I don't have any problems with my siphon right now. So let's continue getting things set up. All right, guys, if you notice, I keep a gallon spray bottle with me. And that's so if I have to do any specific, like really targeted cleaning, where I need a stronger concentration of bleach compared to what it gets siphoned out of. So what I'll do is I'll fill this up with the bleach, and it, like I said, it's already about 1 ounce of dishwashing soap per bleach. Now, some people come on my channel and comment about mustard gas and whatever. Know when to comment, people, seriously. Mustard gas, really? So anyways, I've been doing this for a very long time, and I'm not dying of mustard gas. Of course, I don't stick my freaking face in a bucket either. So, I mean, let's use a little bit of common sense. So what we're going to do is we're just going to pour some of the bleach. We're going to fill up our 5-gallon pail. And if we need a stronger concentration of bleach, then I'll keep a little bit of bleach in one of these and ready to put it into my 1-gallon sprayer if I have to do something, you know, with a stronger concentration of bleach compared to it diluted through the siphon. Let me go ahead and fill up this bucket. All right, guys, so in my pocket, I'll keep my black fan tip. And on my wand, we're going to start out with the pink two-story tip. Now, you see how big that hole is, right? So that's going to work for shooting my soap and bleach all the way up to the top. I already extended the pressure wash line all the way out, all the way around the house. And then I came back with the hose so I can fire up the machine. I can release pressure as needed. Sometimes until the machine warms up, you got to release the trigger, let the pressure out of the pump and stuff like that. Once the pump is going, and remember, of course, your garden hoses should always be on. Once the pump is going, you don't want to not have your hand on that trigger squeezing, letting pressure out. Otherwise, you need an unloader valve. Now we have an unloader valve. It's like some little thing, a little bypass thing, to allow the water to go back through and not back up. So, but it's not right. It's not what I should have. So whatever. So that's why I move kind of fast. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna fire up my machine, and then we're gonna start way in the back corner. We're gonna work ourselves all the way around and finish there delivering our soap. And whenever I say soap, I mean soap and bleach. Or if I say chems, whatever, I mean the bleach and the soap. So let's go ahead and get things going. So we can go to work. Let's go get set up in the backyard. And I'm looking for suds on the window. Once I know I got suds, I know my siphon's working correctly. And there we go. See it? I don't know if you can see it. I see it. I know I'm delivering chemical. So let's wash this out. Some people say start at the bottom and work your way up. I don't see what the difference is. They say it stops it from streaking. I honestly don't know what the hell the difference is. Maybe if you move slow, I don't know. I'll come back and sand tip the bottom. That's a little bit, got a little bit of wind today, so you gotta be careful for overspray, getting the neighbors. I'm gonna switch over to the black tip to do this lower porch. Now I'm avoiding spraying directly into the screen, so what little bit of overspray is hitting it, the screen breaks it up, so it's not really putting chemicals inside the board. See, we move along pretty quick, guys. No messing around.
Get this stuff delivered. And it just, it eats it all up, cleans it all up.
And you see the ceiling here.
Worked around the fan, didn't wet the fan, just work around the fan.
Let's get this area here. This is a mess.
You see the black tip actually reaches, but not with a lot of force. Now you watch this.
It's going to clean it right up. That stuff's going to dissolve right before your eyes.
If this was 10.5% sodium hydrochloride, that'd probably be gone by now. But it takes a little bit longer when you're using just household bleach. Now if I hit it, you see it's just coming right off now. So the difference between commercial grade bleach, sodium hydrochloride, 10.5 or 12%, and household bleach like this, is you gotta put it on again. That's all you got. Not a big deal. Just a little bit more in expenses if it's really, really bad stuff. You know, if you're dealing with a lot of dirt here, a lot of mildew. But if not, 8.25% will be good on. And it's safer to work with. We gotta keep going with the cleaning. That's gonna keep dissolving. We'll come back when we rinse it. That'll all come off with rinse water. So let's keep going. I'm gonna fan tip it first, and then we'll go back and get the peak. Now this side and the back were the worst sides. Your north and your west sides are always going to be your worst sides. But once we get done with these two sides here, then it's really just a matter of rinsing off dirt.
Hey guys, sorry to interrupt this awesome video, but I just gotta say, if you like what you're watching, hit that thumbs up for me, please. It means a lot. And while you're at it, subscribe. Appreciate you.
Rinse the bleach off of them air conditioners, all right? Bleach is corrosive. Do not leave bleach sitting on customers' air conditioners or anything metal. All right. Now, let's see if we can't reach the peak. Pink.
We got it. 4 gallons per minute. Pink tip, guys. Very important. the windows. That's why I like to put silk in my bleach. I know my siphon is working. I'm not wasting time. Right now I'm just coating the vinyl. Next question is, what do I do about fences and staining? It's real simple. Old fences like this that are sun bleached, chlorine's not going to do too much to it. But what I'll do is I'll fan tip it and I'll mist it and I'll blend it. Kind of like fading a paint job on a car. You paint a spot on a car, but you fade it out to match an older color. That's what I'm going to do here. Just mist it, and it's going to blend in. Now, I'm going to let this continue to dwell back there and on the side. Two things you could do now. The worst is over. And I know I shouldn't have my pump just running like this, but whatever. We got the front and that other side to do. They're easy to do. So we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna drive on real quick and we're gonna rinse that off. But if we had some real technical, real hard stuff to do, something that's gonna take a really long time, I would pull my siphon and I would rinse the rest of this house now. I'd rinse off. So I know that I'm done, completely done, and everything's good. But the fact that we're gonna be fast here, probably 10 minutes at the most, to continue dwelling is not hurting anything. But I wouldn't want it to be like 30 minutes because then it just gets really to be a really pain in the ass to clean the windows, to rinse the windows. So I like to rinse the windows and get the film off. So the soap kind of keeps it active right now. It's not air drying. That's what I find anyway. So I'm gonna go ahead and do this front real fast and do that other side real fast. And then we're gonna rinse the whole house and we're gonna get the hell out of here. Too easy, right guys? Sore eyeball. So all that's rinsed real quick, real light. Like I said, there's no mildew and mold or anything like that, just dirt. And same with this, just dirt. So we'll rinse this real quick, or not rinse, but you know, we'll apply the chems, then we'll pull the siphon, go around and rinse the whole house. Bop, bop, bop.
so I misted the fence a little bit. But there's something else I couldn't say because you guys are right next to that pressure washer. You see that, the gable fan, the gable vent? You gotta cascade the water, okay? You don't shoot it right in there. That goes right into their attic, and that wets their insulation. Now, there's usually a screen there that would also help break up the water so you don't have a stream of water going in. But when you're going up for that peak, you wanna make sure you're misting on a downward angle so you don't go right in that gable. Kinda hard to see, but that's what I was doing. Right here on this peak, on this fascia, going on a 45 degree angle, see a little bit of mildew? Let me hit that real quick. A little bit more up there. Let me hit that, and then we're done. All right, guys, let's rinse. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna pull the hose off the siphon. We're gonna run around the back of the house, and we're just gonna rinse. Concentrating on metal, concentrating on windows. Hey, just a heads up. I unplugged my siphon, and I looked in my 5-gallon pail, and I got like maybe this much bleach left, probably about a half a gallon. So we used about 3.5 gallons of bleach on this two-story home. And it's in pretty rough shape back there too, so that's the cheap bleach. We would have probably used 25% less if we used the stronger bleach. When I say cheap, I mean not as strong. But it's not cheaper in cost, it's actually more money buying it off the shelf than buying it in bulk. But we would have used a little bit less, we would have been able to move a lot faster, and we wouldn't have had to second coat some of it, all right? So, but roughly 3.5 gallons of bleach, I guess. We might have used 3 gallons of bleach had we had the good stuff. All right, let's set up on the backside. On that aluminum, I got a little bit of bleach and soap left in my lines before it rinses completely out. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit that real fast and let it just do its thing. We'll just let that do its thing. Let's go ahead and rinse the house. Oh, and if you look, spotless, completely spotless.
Might as well take the dirt off. Okay.
Well, there we go. I mean, that is a very nice, well-cleaned house. Looking pretty good. I am going to plug my siphon back in though before I leave, and I'm going to hit that aluminum and let that soak one more time, because that's not acceptable. So I'll get that a little bit better. I didn't see that the first time around because I didn't come out here, but I'll get it. And that's also where you can use a hand sprayer. If that was like a lower area and you could reach it and you're like, oh shit, I missed something, you can use your little hand sprayer and get that squirt away. Now, for the sake of saving some time and not making this too long of a video, I'm gonna shut down the camera, I'm gonna rinse the house real quick, and then I'll be back. I killed the machine, I leave the garden hose running, I take the wand off, I open my siphon up, and I'm rinsing my siphon right now. So I'm rinsing all the bleach and everything out of that siphon so it doesn't corrode in there. So I'm gonna let that happen for a little while I roll up the hoses and stuff like that. So we're done. The house is done. The house is clean. I had to touch up this gutter one more time. Not a big deal. And I touched up the back like I had said. I ended up using all 4 gallons of bleach. I mean, there's such a little bit of bleach left. But yeah, I used 4 gallons of bleach to do this whole house. And it was pretty rough. And like I said, it's only the 8.25% bleach. So, but I mean, we are good. We were spotless. And then that looked good. That's tar. There's nothing I can do with tar. But that looks good. The house is done. So, I mean, this took me a long time because I'm walking around with you guys and, you know, we're messing around with the camera. But I mean, this house right here, I get here. Say I get here at 10 o'clock, I'd be rolling the hoses up by 11 o'clock the latest. 4 gallons of bleach. So 12, 13 bucks. Can't complain, guys. So I'm gonna roll up my hoses and we're gonna get out of here. And as far as the lawns, the crew working called me, customer came down the street, new customer, paid for the month in advance, gave the money to my guys. My guys called me, the customer called me, so there's no hanky stuff going on there. So that's working out pretty good. So lawn business is growing and house wash business is going. So we're mowing, we're growing, we're going, and we're washing.
This is what we came in for.